San Marcos. It's a bustling town full of bright-eyed young adults who are always on the move. On any given day, you'll find this energetic young crowd down in streets or at the local establishments, whether it be visiting the local coffee shops, vintage stores, or lounging in Sewell Park by day, or going to Latin night or rooftop bar by night. But up until this point, there's been few other events quite like this. The Brunch Club, led by Marcus McNeil, is an organization founded by a group of dedicated young leaders looking to create a community around brunch culture here in San Marcos. Though it was only formed less than 6 months ago, the organization has already made waves amongst the locals and only shows signs that it will continue to grow.
Hello, my name is Gilson Umunnakwe. I'm the Chief Financial Officer of the Brunch Club, and I'm also on the executive board team.
My name is Nyah Pinkett, and I am I don't really have a title, but I'm more so the coordinator for event and kind of like within the people. So I kind of make sure I walk around and make sure everybody's having a good time. I get feedback on the events to see what we can have for the next one, as well as just making sure everything runs smoothly.
My name is Marcus McNeil, and I'm the CEO and one of the founders of the Brunch Club. The Brunch Club was started so that the Black community could really just come together and network in a way that is different than a regular party, not at nighttime, and just nice attire, just having a good ass time.
We didn't expect it to grow on the scale that it did, but we started the Brunch Club, something to give back to the community. Marcus McNeil, Chief Executive Officer of the Brunch Club, brought it to my attention. He was like, hey, this is something I've always wanted to do. So we started doing small little get-togethers with friends, cooking brunches, whether it's breakfast food or even dinners. It was just us and like a group of friends just come and putting food together, like kind of like a potluck. And I told Marcus, I said, hey, this can be something we can, you know, keep going, because I know this is your idea. You wanted something along the lines of bringing brunch and changing up the vibe of Texas State and removing that party vibe of Texas State and bringing more culture to it.
When I think of a brunch, I think of good food, good people, good energy, laughing, dancing, having a good time. And I didn't see it in San Marcos really, because there wasn't establishments really that had brunches. If they did have a brunch, it was really expensive, and a lot of students just didn't go. And I was going to Austin all the time, and I just got really tired of going to Austin just to get brunch. And so I was like, let me bring it to San Marcos. Let me figure out a way and put something together and bring the vibes and the energy that I want here to San Marcos.
And he was like, okay, well, we need a venue. After the brunch that was done for the Thanksgiving can drive, we started to pick things back up the following year. Once we picked things back up the following year, that's whenever the Brunch Club exploded to the numbers that you see today.
I truly did not expect the numbers that we have seen at the past couple brunches. I always thought it was going to be at least, you know, my dream was at least 50 people or 100 people, not close to 400 people, 300 and something plus people coming to our brunches. And to have that in a place in San Marcos, and to be able to have a business that is Black owned and operated, and the people that come to it are Black folks, like, I saw that happening, but not at the scale at which it's happening now. And each brunch, it just gets bigger and bigger and bigger.
Having like over 300 people was just like, oh my God. We did not know we were going to hit that many people.
It's crazy seeing a small organization turn into a huge, not necessarily a huge business, but turn it into a business itself. Now we're reaching out and meeting with different type of restaurant owners, meeting with different type of not club owners, but bar owners who would love to host a brunch club and events, and even apartment complex managers who want to host it, because they know we bring numbers.
I didn't see the growth. The amount of people. I didn't realize that a lot of people liked brunch as much as we did. And it brought like a good impact on the community and helped everybody get involved with something that's, you know, it's a party, but it's not too much of a party.
One of the most noteworthy things about the Brunch Club is that it has become a space for young people of color in the community to dress up, socialize, and dance during the day. Something that the town hasn't seen on such a regular basis in years, if ever.
I feel like the Brunch Club has did an excellent and phenomenal job with bringing Texas State students together. The main focus that Texas State has always talked about is the diversity and the diversity inclusion, but the Brunch Club has took that and brought it to a bigger scale.
I love the Brunch Club because it's unapologetically Black. And there's nothing wrong with being a business that is unapologetically Black. We welcome everyone. But I love that most of the patrons that do come and most of the people that do come and enjoy brunch with us do happen to be Black students who feel like they always hear that they feel like they're at a family reunion, or they feel like they're with their people every time they come because it's in a space where they don't feel judged, they don't feel pressured, they don't feel like they have to dress a certain way or do a certain thing. They just know they can come and have a good time. And that's really the whole goal of Brunch Club, is for everyone to come together, have a good time, enjoy themselves, and feel validated in their experience.
It can bring a lot of different people involved. You know, we aim for the students here at Texas State, but you know, it can be any alumni here or, you know, family, friends, anybody that really wants to come can come. And I think that's really important to be able to have something that's not just a big party, not, you know, not ratchet. It's not doing too much, and it's the right amount of fun, especially on a Sunday. And it kind of gives everybody like, okay, we got the week coming up. It gives you something to look forward to. It's very important for everybody to be able to network and be able to not only just do that, but unwind, relax, and just have a good time and let all the stress of school kind of alleviate.
It's just the fact that people, we can go through so much, you know, and there's so much going on in this world. If you know that at this day on this month, I'm going to enjoy myself. If I can provide that hope and that drive to help get somebody through a time period because they know on this day, I'm going to be able to just let my hair loose and just have a good ass time. That's enough for me.
I've loved seeing the camaraderie that's happening with people on this, like within this community, how people are, you know, coming in and having great vibes, and they're pretty much releasing their stress from school, releasing their stress from life to just come together, eat food, you know, get some mimosas, if you're of age, of course, and just chill with some friends, even inviting their out-of-town friends. That's what I like seeing about this.
Seeing all the work pay off at the actual event is the best, and seeing everybody dressed up nice is always a plus.
Hopefully the Brunch Club grows, and the future candidates are able to pretty much top what we have done in the past. So that way, you know, whenever we come back for homecoming, I'm expecting a brunch.
In the future, I just would like to see it continue here in San Marcos. We're gonna be breaking off and have some in different cities and do some different things. We have other opportunities coming our way, but we're always gonna wanna keep it here in San Marcos because of what it provides the students in the community of San Marcos, but also what it provides the Brunch Club with. And that's with culture. And we'll always continue to pay into culture because culture is a currency. And people have to understand that when you buy into a culture and you do right by people and you look after these folks, they'll look after you. And I can definitely say that San Marcos and surrounding community has looked after the Brunch Club by attending our events and being a part of our family.
If you have any ideas or the public has anything they want to kind of suggest for us to do, we are open to all suggestions, and we're just trying to make it the best event possible on a Sunday.
It's clear that the Brunch Club is here to stay and that it will continue to be a hub of culture and festivity for many more days to come.